This is Caleb Patterson with Midwest Muscle out here at LA Fitness in Tinley. I'm here with the original, the originator of basically natural bodybuilding. Put the name on the map where it actually meant something at meeting, John Hansen. John, I'm just so thrilled and honored that you're actually in my house, in the gym that basically we do the Monster Monday.
Yeah.
I'm just amazed that you're in this area. Now, you're actually doing something else for LA Fitness a little bit further up north. You want to talk about that?
We just did a meet and greet, basically, at the one on 102nd in Cicero, new LA Fitness.
And, so many people calling you and you just making this kind of time. Thank you. I really want to say thank you for that. Because it's always good to see you. And especially with, you doing so much for natural bodybuilding and actually taking the time. Because some people actually forget about where they came from. And I noticed that you've always held tight to your roots, Illinois and in your home. Mm-hmm. You move, but you still make time to come back and see us in your area. And most of the time, once they get away, they want to stay with us. And you keep coming back. And, I really appreciate it. And we've got a show coming up for you in April. And one of the things that really blew me away is that it's not just a bodybuilding show. You actually attach something to it.
Yeah, we're gonna donate some of the funds to the MS Society.
Yes, and it's like, you always come up with something new and original. And I know that, you have a partner in this, Kimmy.
Yeah.
And so this is kind of close to home for you.
Yeah, it was Kimmy's idea, actually, to donate some of the funds to the MS Society. So.
And if you go beyond natural bodybuilding, and go into the arena of basically the regular community. That's pretty big. It's very original, and I'm very proud that you would even think to delve into that arena where it's not just about bodybuilding, it's not just about competitors. Because I know you really started keening in on that. Well, you've always been with the competitor, but now it's just more than just a competitor. You're actually delving into the mainstream.
Yeah. Well, bodybuilding, as you know, is great for health.
Yes.
Obviously. So it's great that we can help out a cause, and I think this can be a big show. So I think the money we make will help.
Oh yes, and especially with being able, it's one of the first shows that we're actually becoming. And actually, starts the base of the national bodybuilding.
Yeah, the season.
So you really gotta come out the box, and it's gonna be hard to top something with an MS Foundation. A hand in that. I'm really amazed that you guys would take that and actually, make it happen. So, I think you're changing the arena.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hollywood High School, now we're going to be at Hinsdale South High School, which is in Darien.
That's even close.
Yeah.
Now, Darien, Hinsdale, that's a school.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, so the people that are not familiar with it, it's still close in the region. You didn't go that far away, but you're getting closer to the mainstream roads and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, kudos to that.
Yeah, thanks.
And what have you been doing in between? Because I know the last time I saw you actually won the universe.
Yeah.
And you didn't. I don't think you took any time off from the gym. Obviously. I think one of my friend Mike was actually admiring your lats while we were talking earlier. So you haven't been slacking there. What do you got going on for the rest of the year? Because the year's almost over.
Yeah.
Basically, the year's in. What do you have planned as far as John Hansen just the person?
Well, 2013 should be a big year. We're going to add another show. We usually did two shows. We did one in April and then one in August.
Mm-hmm.
August was our North America, National North America. So we're going to move the National North America back a little bit, I think, from the fall to October.
Okay.
And so it'll be after the National Universe, which will move to Chicago.
Oh.
So our National North America will be from, which used to be in August, will now be in October. And we're going to add a show in Tampa, Florida, where I live now. We're going to add that in like July.
Breaking news.
We're going to have a show in the summer in Tampa. So we'll have three shows this year.
Wow, and I'm sure with just your name attached that you'll get quite the competition in Tampa. I mean, especially in the summer.
Yeah.
People are taking summer vacations, and some people. There are a lot of people that will hold their diets even on vacation. And Tampa would be the place to find out who did.
Yeah.
So that's going to be interesting to see who shows up for that.
Well, Florida's a big, big place for bodybuilding. You know, in the summertime, they have shows like every weekend.
Mm-hmm.
So they don't have a lot of natural shows. They have a lot of NPC shows. So we'll be one of the few natural shows out there. So if we promote it right, I think it'll be a big show.
So you're basically breaking some more ground, breaking new ground.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that's a challenge that you're looking forward to, because I don't think you've ever backed down from a challenge. At least not that I know of. And, you know, one of the things I'd like to ask, because, you know, now there's another generation coming up.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, when I was growing up, we had Arnold Schwarzenegger. Now the people that are natural competitors have you. How does that feel?
Oh, it's great, you know, to be looked at as, you know, one of the leaders or one of the originators. I'm not an originator of natural bodybuilding, but if people remember my name still, I think that's great.
Yeah,
it's a great compliment.
Well, I mean, you know, like, it's just funny when, like, when I was telling you the people that were coming to the gym, and they were like, well, he's going to be there. We want to meet him, and, you know, it's John Hansen, and they're telling me things, you know, I thought only the natural community, because we're not as well known. And as you know, the IFBB and the other
organizations.
So to hear them breaking down your life to me, it really says you've transcended.
Yeah.
And I said, well, this is our honor. You have become our honor, Schwarzenegger. And it's really a compliment to you. And like I said, because you never really got away from your roots, I think it's amazing because you stayed so attached to it that people have become so attached to you. And, you know, what would you tell the people that want to compete? Because the natural competition is a lot different. I've learned that.
Yeah.
It's a lot different than, you know, the other competitions. So what would you tell the up-and-comers?
As far as competing?
Yes.
Well, my advice, you know, to all the natural bodybuilders is just make sure you're in really good shape, be really ripped. You know, as you know, the natural bodybuilding shows aren't all about size.
Yes.
We're not using any performance-enhancing drugs, so it's just basically what we can do on our own. So usually the winner is the guy who's the most ripped and presents himself the best. And if they're not ready to compete, they can always go to shows and watch it. Like, they want to just come and watch the show, go to the pre-judging event show, see what it's all about.
Uh-huh.
But it's just really about being in shape, you know, being really ripped and presenting yourself that way. That's usually the guy who wins.
And one of the things that I love about it is, like you always talk about, is that when you step off stage, you're still a person that has a life, and you can actually be healthy living away from the stage, you know. And there's been some people that have been, I guess, too involved in their thinking of how they compete, and they're almost destroyed when they don't win. What do you say to the person that overdoes? You know, it's like, if I don't win and I lose, my life's over.
Yeah.
You know, how do you console a person like that?
Well, I've done that myself in the past. I put too much pressure on myself and gotten ready for a show, and it was like, it just overwhelmed me. And, you know, the good thing about losing is that it really motivates you to come back. You know,
yes.
I've always done my best after I've lost a show, not after I won a show.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've always really made the most improvement and done the best with my physique after a bad loss and after a big win. You know, and then you're more motivated to come back and you go, I'm going to show them, I'm going to prove it to them.
Yes.
But yeah, you're right. I mean, you can definitely put too much pressure on yourself and try and, you know, we have to understand with bodybuilding, you can only do so much. You can only do what you can do. A lot of it, like, you don't know who you're going to be competing against. You don't know what the judges are going to do. So the only thing you can concentrate on is yourself. You can't really focus on your competition or what's going to happen. You have to think like a winner, you have to prepare like a winner, and then do the best you can. If you don't win, like I said, it's going to motivate you to come back even better next time. But if you know you've done your best, and Arnold used to always say that, as long as you know you've covered all aspects, you did your diet right, you did your posing right, you practiced your posing, you did your training, and you did the best you could to get ready. And if it didn't go right, you're going to learn from that, and then you can do better next time. You know, that's the whole idea of competition, is to motivate you. I started competing when I was 16, and it really motivated me to get better.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I made so much more progress as a teenager competing. I did 10 teenage shows from 16 to 19. If I wouldn't have competed during my teenage years, even if I would have been training, I wouldn't have been as driven to really make progress.
Mm-hmm.
When you know you're getting up on stage and you know you have to face these guys in competition and beat them, and what you have to improve on, that's what the idea of competition is all about. That's what really motivates you.
And I, I really appreciate and respect that you would say that, you know, you can admit that you love and that it didn't kill you. Yeah. I mean, people, you have to understand, you know, because last year I saw it more than I wanted to, where people were just heartbroken that they didn't win. And it's like, well, I'm never going to do this again. And I said, you know, that's what this isn't what it's about. It should be about, you know, you looking your best, like you said, presenting your best.
Yeah.
And if it's not the best that you can be, then get back.
Right.
And
well, bodybuilding is a tough sport because it's not just the training, it's also the diet.
Yes.
You know, we go through extreme dieting. We have to get our body fat levels so low, and that does affect your mind. It makes you crazy, you mm-hmm. know. And when you're doing that for months at a time to get ready, you know, then you lose. It is devastating. It is really hard. So mm-hmm. the only thing you can do is, like I said, just do the best you can do. Control what you can control, your diet, your training, your attitude on stage makes a big difference.
Yes.
You know, your posing.
Oh my God, yes.
And that's the best you can do. And if it doesn't go your way, I've done a lot of shows. I've probably done 45 plus shows in my life.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of shows just don't go your way, and some shows do go your way. But like I said, the best thing about losing is you can always come back. And this is how life is. You know, life isn't always up high.
Yes.
Downs and up. Everybody has that. Everybody goes through bad times in their life. We lose people. We get disappointments. We get our heart broken. But you can always come back, and you can always, you know, get better.
Exactly.
And that's where the motivation comes. The best thing about competition is it motivates you to be your best. And that's what competition should be.
Now, I would be remiss not to let you get a shout out, because, like, it is the end of the year, and it's time of reflection. Is there anybody you'd like to thank, shout outs, or sponsors, anybody you'd like to give some kudos to?
Well, I'm still with Optimum Nutrition, American Bodybuilding, mm-hmm. and I still write for Iron Man Magazine. So I've
yeah.
been with both of those companies for quite a long time. I've been writing for Iron Man for over 12 years.
You actually made the cover.
Yeah, I made the cover in 2011.
Now, how did that feel?
Oh, that was great, because I tried to do it like 5 times, and I was never good enough. They don't just give it to anybody.
You exactly, yeah.
Really great shape. So, yeah, I was finally glad to make it at the age of 48.
Now, how about that?
Yeah.
It's never too late, you know?
Yeah. And then Kimmy, my partner, and helping me promoting the shows. We had two really good shows this year.
Yes. And, I mean, even the competitors were saying how much better it was. It's
yeah.
really run.
Our
so you know
show,
you made some vast yeah. improvements in it. And thank you for that. Yeah.
Yeah. So we're looking forward to a good 2013. And, Powerhouse Gym out in Tampa, Florida. That's where I train. I think that's one of the best gyms ever in Tampa, Florida. You gotta go to the
I'm
Powerhouse
sure I will
gym
be.
Downtown Tampa. It's like the best gym around. So, yeah, it's been good.
And you've been, like I said, you never strayed away to the point you got away from your roots. And I think that's the best thing for National Bodybuilding, because we always had a face in you. And like I was saying when we were over in Chicago, how it just blew me away that because you stayed so close, people were coming just to see if you were there. You know, and that's awesome, because we were at the universe and they just want to see John.
Mm-hmm.
How about that? You know, we got Australia, we had France, yeah. Italy, yeah. all these different countries, and they just want to see John. So I was there. I know I was in the audience, because I was trying to catch up with Jody Miller, and somebody said, well, you know, can you just get out of the way? I'd like to see John. And I was thinking, well, okay, yeah. So, you know, thank you so much.
Thank you,
thank you for stopping in and, you know, to the Midwest Muscle House.
Yeah.
And Kimmy, thank you. John, thank you again. Midwest Muscle. Flex and Joe, I wish you guys were here to be with this guy. He's awesome. We are out.